Everybody, it's Evicta. Sun Continuing Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support here. The like streak is currently on hold because we have not reached 2,000 likes in yesterday's video quite yet. And also, the meme of the day isn't really a meme of the day, but it is an accomplishment or achievement of the day. Special shout out to TMT Venial for being the 5,000th subscriber on Reddit. I did see that post there, so thank you very much to Venial for joining the subreddit Mosh Pit. Making a thread about it. It was fantastic. C-Day is going to be 8-3, Bravo, 9, 1, Golf, 4-0. Got good damage, good shot speed. Well, kind of okay shot speed. Good tiers rate, bad movement speed. We also have 9 lives, and also have the potato peeler, which I'll probably just use immediately. But yeah, not a bad start, of course, and having 9 lives is going to give us some forgiveness if we happen to goof up a little bit here and there, which is more than likely to happen. Because let's be honest, we make some pretty bad plays every now and then. Although I will say that we had a pretty clutch win on stream tonight where I was unfortunate enough to get bamboozled by the mosh pit. And I gave in to their demands to take a blind item, and it turned out it was guillotined. But this time, unlike we had last week where I did lose the Twitch streak, thanks to Guillotine. This time around, I actually had redemption, and we ended up winning that run on stream. So that was pretty awesome. It was a clutch victory. Most of the victory does go to the fact that we got saved by a random devil deal, which essentially put us into. Okay, I'm not gonna take that soul heart because I'm not gonna take the soul heart yet because obviously we're probably going to. End ourselves here just well, anyway we're going to end ourselves over here on this floor because obviously we want to get our red heart back so we can have some currency to use in the next devil deal, which is the reason why I'm leaving that soul heart behind. So I don't really care if we lose a life here. It's not that big of a deal. And plus, we get the added bonus of having the potato peel to give us a damage upgrade, and of course, the orbital. But going back to the run on stream tonight, it was mostly due to Little Monstro, of all things, as the familiar that ended up helping us out the most. And then after that, I ended up rage picking up in the chest Dr. Fetus and Monstro's Lung, just because I was like, yeah, we're done. We're not going to win this because we only have 1 HP. We had 9 lives, and we were down to our last life. But Dr. Fetus ended up pretty much ending the run for us in the best way, just because it was so much combined damage. And on top of that, in the chest, we randomly got teleported to the Devil Deal, which had Gimpy, and it also had 2 black soul hearts, and that actually allowed us to get rid of our red heart container and get Gimpy, and then it was all she wrote for Blue Baby after that. Yeah, so I don't mind dropping a life there. At all, as I already said. Now, we could also, if I really wanted to, we could be really, really greedy here, and I think I'm actually going to do that. We could be really greedy with the potato peeler and go for a level 4 meat boy and a level 1 cube of meat again, and on top of that, we'll also gain a massive amount of damage up. Yeah, that seals the deal right there. Now, I don't remember. I'm not 100% sure. Can you? Okay, you can. So this is going to look a little bit wonky, and you're going to think that this is a big waste, but trust me, it's not. it's not as big of a waste as you may think it is. Because remember, we're giving ourselves damage upgrades, but more importantly, we're giving ourselves a level 4 meat boy, which does an amazing amount of damage, especially early on. And on top of all of that, we're maintaining our Cuban meat orbital while still having 4 lives left. But the biggest thing that we get out of this is the damage upgrade, of course. Level 4 Meat Boy does a very good amount of damage. I think right here, of course, if we get BFF in the shop, that's going to be even more damage. And we get a Tears upgrade, which is fine by me. Going to raise our DPS fairly high. Go back and get this Soul Heart. So a little bit of a weird, wonky start here to this one, but it's in all the right reasons, for all the right reasons. We could look for the possibility of getting that car battery. We might as well take the car battery because, I mean, it's car battery. It's not going to work very well with the potato peeler, of course, but we're not going to use the potato peeler anymore. unless we get another 9 lives, which is possible, but unlikely. We, of course, also got Sad Bombs, which is a fantastic pickup for us. Not only because it gives us Sad Bombs, but also it gives us 5 extra bombs that we can use. So this is what I would consider a primo start. It's not the best start of all time, but it's definitely one of the better ones. I did feel pretty good about winning that Guillotine run, especially after losing the Twitch streak last week to Guillotine. I wasn't feeling very... I was feeling off my game last week. And the fact that we ended up pulling this one out, it was reserved in my mind that we were going to lose that run. I was like, yeah, we got Guillotine and Curse the Blind. There's just no way. And, you know, I wasn't really feeling like I was playing my best, but I really hunkered down and ended up getting the win. And I'm not really giving myself enough credit there because even though you're like, whoa, you got built up by Dark Fetus in the chest. It's like, yeah, but the thing is that we were stuck on 1 HP for the majority of all of Womb 2, the Cathedral, and the chest. And even though that doesn't sound like that big of an accomplishment, the problem is that we also had the Guillotine. Guillotine is straight up just one of my most hated items in there. So we are going to get one of the best items in the game here, however... With Twanky, how you doing? I got asked, why do I ask random items, how you doing? Like, how you doing, sissy, and whatnot. Just a habit that I formed over the years. I don't know why. I'm kind of an idiot. I don't know. I like personifying items and stuff. There's a certain level of comfort if you can imagine it. Imagine yourself talking to an item like you're the coach and it's a player trying to be on the team, sort of thing. You know, there's a certain level of comfort factor in that. It helps you kind of, I guess in a way, compartmentalize a like emotions towards an in-game item that is completely not conscious of its own being, you know, like I don't know, it's a weird topic, but it's something that I do quite often. Look, you gotta think of some creative ways to keep yourself entertained, but more importantly, to keep everyone who's watching entertained. I will go all the way back and go into the curse room here, even though I didn't really want to go like with this movement speed all the way back there. It's worth it if it gives us a couple soul hearts, or even better, if it gives us like a better Devil Deal item than the shovel. Shovel's not really going to make it for us here. I do have a couple of announcements though. First off, for those of you who are interested in filling out your tournament brackets, we have concluded the Meet the Teams thread series on our subreddit over /r/Invicta. And you only have, I believe, until the 28th is when it expires. Emeros is the one who set up the... it's a free form, and I almost walked into that. Essentially, you only have until the 28th. So if you're planning on making brackets for the tournament, make it soon. Make it very, very soon. And post it to the forums. Because that's the only way that you'll be entered in for the whatever prize we end up eventually getting. As far as the tournament goes, I've been working on it slowly but surely. Been having a lot of computer issues. The CPU tweaks that myself and a member of the Mosh Pit attempted to help me with did not take, unfortunately. I received a nasty string of blue screens last night around 3 a.m. when I was trying to stream RimWorld, because I was playing the new RimWorld expansion, and I eventually had to go back into the BIOS and load the optimized defaults, which erased all of the tweaks that I had done on it, and then I was having more blue screen issues, which was the original blue screen issue that I was getting a couple months ago. So I had to deal with that, and I fixed that by adjusting power settings in the voltage and whatnot in the BIOS. So, needless to say, It's not been a fun couple of days. between having some pretty bad Isaac runs, at least on stream anyway, and fighting with the computer just to stay running. You know, it's been challenging to stay positive. Let alone motivated to continue to edit. So I deliberately took Skinny on Mushroom here to max out our tiers rate. Of course, that does also give us a much-needed movement speed boost. I wouldn't mind getting more options here. The secret room is to the left of the room that we were just in, by the way. It's down there, right where I shot. But we don't have any bombas, unfortunately. Five thousand people joining the subreddit, man. It's just so awesome. It's that sort of weird satisfaction I get from seeing something that was restored. I've been on a kick about like watching there's giant YouTube channels on YouTube that are all about just like restoring like old cars. Lately, I've been watching like the detailing this channel. I think his name is the Detail Geek or Detailing Geek or something like that. But he runs a very entertaining channel where he takes like really, really nasty cars and trucks and then like does a detail work on them. He's got professional tools and everything and shows like, you know, the transformation. They're like 30-minute long videos and stuff. And of course, I skip around. I usually skip to like the last 10 minutes and then watch it on times two because like I really don't want to watch someone washing a car for that long. But it's entertaining. It's that same level of satisfaction I see whenever we have something that really wasn't being utilized at all and turn it into something that is now being utilized and have some pride into and whatnot. And, you know, it just makes you feel good. And now we have 5,000 strong on the subreddit and counting. I was also told we have nearly 133,000 subscribers on YouTube as well, which I have not been keeping up with. I think that's like 3,000 subs we've gained in like the last week or something crazy like that. So it's been a remarkable time for the channel, and you know, I couldn't be happier or prouder of everything that we've accomplished. Of course, Skinny on Mushroom did give us a huge damage down, but it gives us a massive tiers up as well as a movement speed. We get some range here, which is actually something that we kind of needed because we don't have a good shot speed stat, but unfortunately Stanley just keeps on jipping us, so there's nothing we can do about that. Double Ultra Pride, oh boy. So that is the effect that you're seeing right here is the direct effect of that item that just dropped, that trinket, the game cartridge. It has a chance to give us invincibility, essentially turning us into Game Kid, where you have invincibility, you turn into Pac-Man, and you actually do deal damage, and you recover red heart HP for everything that you destroy like that, in that invincibility state. So it's very, very good. But the left hand is just better. The left hand is going to turn all chests that drop into red chests or dark chests, which have a very high tendency to pay out with soul hearts, sometimes guppy items if you're lucky, sometimes even trips to the devil deal. And unfortunately, even though we're on floor six right now. No, it's floor four. What am I talking about? We still don't have a devil deal locked in because we haven't gotten items that are worth it. We've only gotten one devil deal that had items in it. It was the shovel. Which leads me to... It doesn't really lead me into it, but it kind of takes me to the next topic, I guess. Where I don't usually talk about Twitch like subs and stuff. We gotta take SMB Superfan. I need to get back the damage that we lost from Skinny on Mushroom. I normally don't talk about like Twitch goals and stuff, but what I will say is that I just introduced a new sub incentive on my Twitch channel, twitch.tv/Sinvicta. Not Sinvicta316, but just regular Sinvicta. If we hit it, I will do a full stream of the racing mod or the speedrunning mod for Isaac. I think that'd be very interesting. I recently went back and rewatched the AGDQ run on YouTube from this year, from this past year, where Casper was sitting on the couch with Zam, I forget his name, the person who made the mod. Because I wanted to see what I had missed over that. Wow, that yellow champion was moving. So I thought it'd be a neat little incentive to do a full stream of me trying my hand at the speedrunners mod. It's a very interesting mod, and I think that it's a good incentive, and also I think that a lot of people would love to see that. If we somehow did end up hitting that sub goal, and it's a pretty substantially high sub goal, but if we do hit that though, I will put that on YouTube as well. So if you've ever thought about supporting my channel on Twitch, now's a great time to do so. We had a ton of gifted subs tonight on Twitch, and we're well on our way. But I just wanted to plug the Twitch channel a little bit if you want to see some live Isaac. I've never done racing. I've never done speed running in any game, let alone Isaac. Finally, we get some shot speed here. Get a Joker card and nothing. Oh, thank you. Thank you, alternating wick timers. Well, there goes all of our soul hearts. I guess I'll take the Trinity Shield, and I'll take the key piece. We'll head on down. There's the lost, hooray. Let me adjust something really quick here. But yeah. 2020 so far has been a tumultuous first quarter of the year almost now as we approach March. But a good one. It's been tumultuous in the best ways possible. Outside of a couple of hang-ups, of course. You know, but there's no reason to focus on the negative. The only thing that negatives are good for making you appreciate the positives. It helps you, for me anyway, it assists me in recognizing how important it is to have balance in everything. Maybe a big old troll bomb jamboree in here, I guess. I really don't feel like doing this. Cliff of Balance, hooray. No, thank you. Not even worth picking up, if I'm honest. I don't know. It's just to me it's always good to see the other side of the coin, you know. As someone who frequently has a lot of, let's just say, unfortunate circumstances happen, whether in video games or otherwise, being able to focus on the positives is pretty important here. Book of Sin, abso-freaking-lutely. Especially with car battery here, you're seeing the love. Seeing that love. Answers. Not really going to help us on a Curse of Loss, but you know what? I like where your head's at. Black Root, I am going to drop the Ansa's Root over here just so we don't consume it. And then I will use the Black Rune. Thank you very much to the Potato Peeler. Your gentleman and a scholar, thank you for the pretty significant speed upgrade, actually. All right, we'll hold on to the Ansa's Rune until the next floor and then use it there. Unless, of course, we get Curse of Loss, then I don't have a choice. Now, you definitely could have argued, well, you should have saved the Black Rune for the double item room that you're going to get soon. And it's like, yeah, I could have. But I didn't. There's a lot of things I could have done, but chose not to. Curse of the Lost also kind of plays a small role in that, just because I really don't want to backtrack through the entire level again. We do have an outside shot. Unbelievably, have an outside shot at getting boss rush. But that's not my main motivating factor in speeding up here. Trinity Shield, by the way, is literally just a shield that sometimes blocks shots. Sometimes. It's not really reliable, though. I've never really had a fondness for it because it gives you a false sense of security, and I think that it's a dangerous thing to have when you're talking about shot mitigation and overall defense in the game. Your main defense should not be based on, well, I've got an item that's just going to block all my forward-facing shots. I'm fine. Your main defense in this game should be, I'm going to dodge everything that is coming my way, and I don't care what kind of items I have. I still need to do that, no matter what. That's my mindset. I will take Scapular. Scapular is a great pickup here. And to be honest, having the having Shielded Tears wouldn't necessarily be bad, especially with 2020. But I'd still rather have Scapular just for the fail safe. Double Soul Heart Pout. Thank you very much. I did go back and listen to the old Hushy. Someone in the AGDQ crowd shouted out old Hushy on the Azazel run. So that was that made me smile. And Casper's such a great guy. A great Isaac player. He's an amazing member of the community. But yeah, I figured that'd be a fun little incentive. See if we can get over the next hurdle of the Twitch goals there. I'm not gonna take Glyph of Balance. Okay. Man, items all the way over there. We don't have a teleportation. I'm just going to skip boss rush. Unless if we get a teleportation card, like from the Book of Sin, in this room that we're in right now, I'm not going to consider going after boss rush. I'm curious to see how I would do with a speed run of Isaac. I was looking at that mod, and on paper, it doesn't seem like it would be that hard. You get to, basically, there's a set number of starting items you get, and you always get the D6. And if you die, you only have to wait a penalty of time. So to me, that sounds like that's a pretty sweet deal. You know? I'm not trying to insinuate that I would have the skill enough to become a speedrunner, but I'd like to just try my hand at it just to see, you know, like, yeah, I'm curious to see how well I could translate stuff to right now. I'm only going to touch the Monster Manual just because I don't like Loki's horns, to be honest. But we have two of the three for the Bookworm transformation right now, so we're pretty good. We is good. Now, all that to say that our damage really isn't that good. I mean, we is good for sure, but our damage is not that great. 4.55 damage is not going to impress the ladies, fellas. You walk into a room and you say, hey, guess who's got 4.55 damage and two thumbs? This guy. 100% guarantee that's not going to score you any points with the ladies. I'm just being honest. But if you walk into that same room and you say, I've got 9.10 damage, you're still not going to get any ladies because they're just going to look at you thinking, like, what the heck is this guy talking about? Like, someone get him out of here. Look, no amount of damage is going to impress the ladies, fellas. I'm sorry. All right. But if they were impressed by such a thing, if they could only be swayed to be so, they would not be impressed with 4.55 damage. Definitely. And this is not coming from a lady, it's coming from a dude. Now we get an Emperor card. All that to say, I hope that we get some good Devil Deal items soon. If any. I mean, we have to qualify for the Devil Deal first, of course. Which is pretty easy considering that we have so many Soul Hearts. Now, we haven't seen a greed fight yet, so I am fully anticipating this being a greed fight in our final store. We made up some good time, though. Considering how slow the first floor took with all that backtracking we did to go into that curse room. And, of course, we were also stopping to do the whole potato peeler shenanigans. Yep. How does he do it? A waste of a full charge, but I don't care. I know there's a luck upgrade in there, and I don't care. The game can have it. I don't need its greed infested charity. I think I'd be okay at it. At least I would know, like, you know, what the items do, and assuming I got lucky and had mapping of some kind. You know, I would put a huge emphasis on mapping for sure. I deal with the devil, no surprise there. Head on down. Sure, why not? Really tempted to use this Emperor card, but I'm not going to. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Loki. You're only going to get me once with that, bro. Not twice. You don't know what happened there. Loki spawned a bomb fly right on us while we were trying to move in for damage there with the Cuban meat. Justice card's very good. Of course, the Emperor card seals the deal here for us. But so far, it's just been a straightforward, solid run. Nothing really spectacular outside of 2020. I definitely think that the potato peeler play at the start was MVP for sure. Even if we didn't have 2020, we would still be in a very good spot here. Skinny on Mushroom coming out of nowhere was also a pretty big deal. It is unfortunate that we didn't have an actual store for our final store, but what can you do? No curse, no curse. Moon card, world card, that's what I'm talking about. Alright, now it's absolutely going off into the wrong way. Only reason why I'm taking the long way here is because I do want to go into the curse room, but I also don't mind getting some charges from our Book of Sin. Book of Sin's going to accumulate a lot of good stuff for us. We need more bombs. We need more HP, of course, to pay for us going in and out of the cursed room. Of course, there's always a chance for us to get red chests along the way, which could take us to the devil deal, blah, blah, blah. But I don't mind going the long roundabout way here. Book of Sin is a book that will spawn random consumables, like hearts, keys, bombs, trinkets, that kind of stuff. Actually, I take that back. I don't think the Book of Sin can spawn trinkets. But because we have car battery, we are heavily incentivized to try to use the Book of Sin as much as possible because of the life-generating aspect of the item. And on top of that, of course, you also have the chance of getting good tarot cards or runes or something like that. So we're effectively getting double our value every time we get a full charge for the Book of Sin. An item that already has an amazing amount of value. And so we will have a full charge after we defeat the boss here. We know it's not going to be Matriarch because we're not in the Scarred Womb, which is pretty good. Is it clubs? No, thank you. Gonna be daddy. What are you doing down here in the womb? You're not supposed to be here. Get another angel deal. I don't really want any more movement speed, to be honest. I'm gonna take dead dove. I want flying. And I guess we'll fight Gabriel here. And before you ask, no. I'm not planning on it. No. I'm only doing this just in case we get something incredible. But for all intents and purposes, no. I will take the movement speed upgrade now that we have flying. So, that being said, it would take a lot to compel me to go fight Megastan, especially after the week that we've had with him. It really, really sucks that we didn't get another Guppy item after starting with 9 lives and then also getting the left hand. Maybe we still have a chance, of course, but it's not a good chance right now. We essentially, if we don't get it here, then we're pretty much done Dizzle for that one. Black Rune is right there, of course. We're not going to find anything to use it on. And I'm not going to give away the Emperor card for it. Emperor card is just way too valuable. Meat Boy, not going to lie, I need you to step up a little bit. Sitting there staring at stuff, while that is hilarious, it doesn't help us clear the room at all. Oh, just give us one Guppy item and we'll be good. Oh yeah, I forgot we had flying. Totally forgot we had flying.
How could you forget you had flying, you nerd? You literally just picked it up.
Look, we're basically in autopilot mode at this point. The Book of Sin and Car Battery is just dependable. Dependable Sin is what I say. And you combine that with the added bonus of having 20/20 and a level 4 Meat Boy and a level 1 Cube of Meat. Brother, you got yourself a one run. We'll take this Eternal Heart because there's no way that we're going to be able to get rid of all this Red Hearts. Especially considering that we have not seen Krampus yet, or have we? Have we seen... I don't think we've seen Krampus on this run. We may have. All the runs are kind of blending in together at this point for me. Now, if you're wondering why sometimes you see 4 shots going out, that is Bookworm proccing with 20/20. This doesn't feel like the right way. Unless it curves upward here. Yeah. Pretty much what I thought. One card, thank you very much. We would have found it eventually. But I appreciate you nonetheless. Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate it. Wow. Shannon Rock is almost always in this room. Super Secret Room is almost always south of this room. Almost always. Keep in mind. A little bit of a misplay there. I should have waited to pick up those extra hearts. Interesting. Get our work in here with Cuban Meat and Trinity Shield if the computer would stop freezing for a moment. Not get a double deal. That's why I have a Joker card. And Rotten Baby as well as missing page number 2. Go back, grab our Emperor card, and head on up. What a run, though. You know, just nothing spectacular. Just it's a run that is built out of solid decision-making and solid items. Really what it comes down to. I don't think I necessarily played all that well in this run. But then again, I also never really... I never say that I play well on any run. And it's not me trying to be modest either. That's how I literally feel. I don't ever feel like I'm playing that great. Isaac. So before we go to the chest, of course, I will be dropping the left hand. Or I might not. I might just hold on to the left hand just in case. I mean, we're guaranteed four chests in the chest. And we're looking essentially just for Guppy items here. We just need one. That's all we need. We started the game with 9 lives, and we got a very early Guppy's Collar. So you would think chances would be good, especially with the left hand, that we would get Guppy. But here we are in the Cathedral. Nothing spectacular about that, fellas, I can tell you that. You walk into that party. If you walk into that party and you're like, hey, girl, I got 2 or 3 Guppy items, I guarantee you, you're not going to have a good time. They're still going to look at you and be like, who is this person? Get him out of here. But you'll get thrown out of that party even faster showing up with 2 or 3 Guppy than having 3 or 3 Guppy, all right? And I'm just saying. He's done it. We got the Gupster. Thank you very much, Book of Sin, for making it all possible. End up with Guppy and Elza hair, or frozen hair. Of course, this is also highly beneficial to us with us having the car battery, because we get essentially two spawning waves of flies per full charge. Gonna fly through the monstrosities there and just create havoc. Not sure how the physics work on that one there, game. Pretty sure that bomb spawned in the middle of those rocks. And last I checked, rocks are pretty solid. Bombs can't really go through them, but hey, what do I know about this game after all? So yeah, come on by the Twitch channel. We always have a good time. They are a little bit more they're a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more casual. Definitely more leaning more towards the PG-13 side for sure. But if you've ever wanted to support my Twitch channel, this is a great time to do it. I think that a lot of people would really be interested in seeing me try my hand at the speedrunning mod. It would just be a nice little side incentive for also gaining a new emote slot as well. I'm banking on us getting teleported to the deal with the devil here. That's the only reason why I'm holding on to the left hand. I just want to see if we can do it. No, 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 and no. I'm just joking. No, I'm not! Round 2! We're back! No, my microphone didn't cut out. I'm just not talking right now. I got a score to settle. So please forgive the radio silence for a moment. Only a moment. I have something that I'm trying to do. All right, well, I was hoping that I was going to be able to get a no-hit against Mega Stan to kind of drive the point home. Didn't quite happen, though. To be fair, I didn't even see that Ipecac shot, but it doesn't matter. It don't even matter, man or woman out there. Thank you very much, everyone, for all the support here. Almost 133,000 strong on the channel. It's unbelievable. And again, thank you for those of you who've been going over to the subreddit as well. It really does make me smile to see the subreddit thriving and growing and you know, to see us having events and stuff, to see us having interesting things going on, good topics, good discussions, good memes, sometimes bad memes, but mostly good memes. It really is a pleasure. So if you enjoyed this video, everyone, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Subscribe and ring the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos go live here on YouTube. And of course, if you see a post-video survey, kindly consider putting us at 5 stars. It is the best way to support my channel right now on YouTube, as well as any other content creator that you like to support here. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!